is Whoops Morning here. So, we're in the car because we're gonna do a vlog today. I'm sorry, I enjoy vlogs. I think they're very fun.
The only one that enjoys vlogs.
I enjoy taping now. I think it's so cool. But, we're in the car. You see, Sissy's all dressed because she's going to work today. They just declared the end. Well, not the end, but they extended the 7-day lockdown.
No, they said it was the 24-hour curfew.
Oh, 24, yeah, sorry. Yeah, 24-hour curfew, 7-day lockdown, whatever. They extended that, but they opened it up for banks. Banks have to open for a couple hours.
About 8 to 12.
8 to 12, yeah, for 2 days, right? 2 days in the
week.
Yeah,
Wednesday and Friday.
Yeah, and then tailors are open.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, because they have to make the masks. Yeah, okay, we have masks. We got masks made. Yeah, it's a little it takes a lot to get used to. And then a couple of, and buses. Yeah, public transportation is open for until 12, right? So after 12, everything is really closed down, but like they're allowing a few things to be open right now. So I'm taking her to work. I'm dropping her to work. Yeah, Benny, tell them why I have to drop you to work.
I don't have time to tell you why she's taking me to work, but she's taking me to work. Okay. You can't see my smile, but I'm smiling.
Isn't that weird? Okay, yeah, Benny, so tell them why. Why I have to drive you to work?
I'm not telling y'all.
Yeah, I have to drive her to work because she doesn't really have an Antiguan license. She's really a tourist right now. She cannot drive here. Okay. She doesn't have an Antiguan license. Yeah, she has a U.S. license. Oh, look at the camera moving. She has to get a visitor's license.
Oh, we're gonna go on our first moon path in Antigua. The best road ever.
Yeah, we're on the airport right now. No traffic, what a thing. So she had the visitor's license, so it's expired. You have to do every 3 months. Hers is expired, so she has to get it renewed. So that's why I'm driving her to work. Like a chauffeur. Oh wow, look at all this open road. But we're gonna have to stop right now though.
Of course.
Not necessarily. Sometimes you get green light. Take this off. Yeah, so how long are you working for today, Vandy?
I already said 8 to 12.
But she's so mean today.
Because how would you feel coming out your house during a pandemic, people?
Vandy, you know there's people that have to in hospitals.
I understand that. But in your mind is not, some people's mind is programmed, okay, a pandemic is happening, so, you know, I chose this career, so, you know, my mindset is placed into that mode. But when you have a person who's mad paranoid, like myself, with things like this, it goes crazy real fast. So, but it's like working my mind around the fact that, hey, you're in the open air where you can easily get it. And what I do at my job, I have to touch a lot of checks. Which obviously we are told that the certain materials or items can have the thing on the droplet, so why would they return it to, can stay on that surface for a certain amount of hours, days, or weeks. So it's really just I don't know how many times I'm gonna do this with sanitizer or have my wipes wiping, spraying the air, because I don't know. Can you inhale this stuff too? Like, I can't even right now. I can't.
She's going through something, but this too shall pass. And as I said, it's only a couple hours, you know? 3 hours, you go, you do
your job. I'm hoping for two. This is the time where you kind of push your limit so you can get home safely. Yeah. So, yeah. We'll see.
There's only a green light.
Yeah, but people still coming through. But they lost. They
even obey the law. If you see a green light, I mean a red light, stop.
Well, not they do that on regular street, but airport light traffic, because they're working on the road, it's not happening.
Yeah, because what happened, for those of you who don't live in Antigua right now, we are doing construction on Fraser Road and Airport Road, right? So there's, at certain points, it's a one-lane road, so they can work on one side at a time. So people not abiding by these traffic signs or traffic lights. They want to run the light because they think they can get over before the other light comes. Like, what is this?
And the road ends.
Yes, no more smooth road.
I know, right? All down here from here. But as she said, she's gonna drop me to work, and she's gonna, I don't know, wanna film me.
Yeah, like we'll film her reaction when we go pick her up. Actually, I think my dad might pick her up. I don't know.
We don't know about that.
She don't really want him to pick her up. He drives really slow.
Oh, and I really would like to get home.
Dad is like the slowest driver alive.
Everybody knows him. If y'all know him by Benji or Sugar, yeah, that's our father.
He drives so slow. It's really dumb. Like sometimes I'm like, I mean, come on, people don't pass people on Old Farm Road, and people passing you here.
Anyways, so the roads is gonna get really bad, and this camera will not stay in place. So we'll talk to you soon, okay?
Yeah, we'll come back. So I'm back. Mommy's in the car now. She's driving. So we're on our way to the supermarket. We just realized that it's Good Friday tomorrow. So we need to get stuff. Good Friday here in Antigua, for those that don't know, it's our huge deal. It's a huge thing. We eat and we eat dukana and all our local dishes and that kind of stuff. So, and like we try to abstain from eating meat. So it's like a huge day for us to eat our local dishes and to, you know, just come together and stuff like that. So, and we're just assuming that everywhere's gonna be closed. Cause usually when we're not in a pandemic, Good Friday's a holiday. So we're right now in trying to get to the supermarket. I'm gonna show you the lines. I mean, when I was dropping out Bendy earlier, there was so many lines. Like the banks were open, as I said, so everybody's trying to get money or pay their bills or whatever it is. So there were a lot of lines, and I feel like that's kind of counterproductive. Like I know the banks were only open for 2 days, but like everybody's still gathering and coming to, and like, you know, like having to be in close quarters to line up to get to the bank. But that's what's happening. So right now we're in line trying to get to the supermarket. I'll show you. I'm pretty sure we're like almost 100% certain that it's gonna be a crazy, crazy, crazy line. But let's see. Yeah. So we're back, and that was a crazy, crazy, crazy experience. Like, my goodness. Like, the first of all, we felt like we were there for at least an hour, standing in the sun. And then when we finally got inside, they said 15 minutes. They kept saying 15 minutes, 15 minutes shopping, 15 minutes shopping. And it felt like shorter than 15 minutes. We went there and we waited an hour. But we understand. But I think we're still impressed because the supermarket had made so many different adjustments. Because when we got to the cashier, and I'm gonna start a video right now, hopefully it came out good. I'm gonna start a video right now so that you can see. That's what I got. Partition.
But
the cashiers not only had masks on, they all had masks on, but they had like a shield. They had a shield as well as a barrier between the customer and the, like, they had put all of this in place just for, you know, Corona. Yeah.
Very impressive. Very, very impressive.
Very surprised to see that adjustment. And they had already set up sinks and that kind of stuff like weeks ago, actually. Sinks so you can wash your hands before you go in the supermarket. But it was nice to see that adjustment. I mean, but when we went to the supermarket, it was like mostly like, not empty, but like everything I was accustomed to being there was not there. Like some of the refrigerators and that kind of stuff was not there. We're just going up the hill now. Trying to hold on to the camera. Yeah, so overall impressed with the adjustments store had made. It was a rush. It was a very rushed experience. So we weren't really too happy about that. But we understand. We went kind of late. And then, you know, they're trying to make adjustments to keep us safe. We appreciate all of that. So we're just on our way home now. Bendy should be getting out of work soon. So I'm just going to check with her and see if she's ready. And then I'll probably be the one going to pick her up. Hey, so this is actually the next day. When I got back from the supermarket, I had a crazy headache. So I've officially canceled masks in my life. Like, I've canceled them in my life because the one I had yesterday gave me an epic headache. Maybe it's because of the sun too. I was in the sun for quite a bit waiting for, you know, to get inside the supermarket, but yeah, I'm done with masks. So I had an epic headache. I just came back from the supermarket and basically just slept the rest of the day because that headache was on epic proportions. I took a pill and that didn't even work. So yeah, so this is the next day. And guess what? It's Good Friday. It's Good Friday. This is the day when Christians all over the world acknowledge the day that Jesus died for all of our sins. And we take this time to acknowledge that. Some of us go to church, you know, today normally we would be at church. And we don't even have an online church today, but we're still going to remember this day, you know, and acknowledge this day as best we can. We in Antigua now, well, in Antigua it's a holiday. I think in the Caribbean it might be a holiday, the whole Caribbean it might be a holiday. So it's a holiday today. So everything, you know, I know we're on lockdown, but everything, even essential workers, which I mean, I don't think that extends to those in the hospital, but even like the police, supermarkets, gas stations, everywhere is closed today. Everywhere is closed today besides the hospital, I think. So it's a real holiday here. In the States, when Benny and I were living in the States, it was not a holiday. And that was so strange to us, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's weird. Yeah, she's right here.
Don't you dare.
Okay. Yeah, she doesn't want the camera on her. But I just got threatened. But yeah, so it's not a holiday in the States. So that was a little weird. That's because we just grew up it being a holiday. Like we have Friday as a holiday and then Easter Monday, which is a Monday after Easter, as a holiday. So like everywhere's closed on those 2 days. So today's Good Friday. So what we normally do, we eat food or meat that doesn't have I guess they don't bleed. I don't know what the thing is, but we don't eat like regular meat. So we eat fish. Fish is allowed on Good Friday, but everything else. And I won't say allowed. It's like no law, but it's just our practice. Part of our culture is what we do. So we don't consume any meat on this day, Good Friday. So somebody probably will tell me what that's about. The actually what that's about. But it's part of our culture. We just eat fish that day. So Antiguans take it upon ourselves to eat our national food, our cultural dishes. Yes. So normally we'd have fungi and sawfish, or dukkan and sawfish, or potato dumpling and sawfish. There's so many different variations because most of our national dishes don't include any like real meat products like pork or chicken or anything like that. So that's good. So today I'm just gonna, you're gonna see some of that, I guess. We're actually taping a Antiguan kitchen video. I don't know what mother has plans, but she has it all planned out.
Alexa, stop.
Sorry, that was a classic.
Alexa, play When You Believe by Mariah Carey and Lavender Memphis.
Sorry, what was that?
The one that died, what's her name?
Whitney Houston.
Thank you.
It might not always feel like it, but there are people who can help. Please know that you can call the National Suicide Prevention.
What? Alexa, take your suicidal.
I'm done.
Alexa, play a Whitney Houston song.
No.
What is?
What of that?
Circles a revolving door. Feeling transcendental over 3.14. I'll take a slice of that never ending pie. A never ending slice. Oh me, oh my.
Alexa.
Rap, you got served.
Alexa singing. Okay.
Sorry, I'm not sure about that.
Sorry. I didn't mean to play that. Look, but
just in a state of giving thanks and that kind of stuff, because this is the day that God, well, Jesus sent his son to die
on the cross.
On the cross for our sins. So it's a sad day. Not sad.
It's a
solemn day. Solemn in like thoughts. You know, we're thinking about what went through and what transpired. I'm pretty sure ABS is gonna show the Passion of the Christ.
Oh, I don't know about y'all, but I ain't watching it.
So we have an opportunity to watch that again.
I'm not watching it. I can't handle it.
But, yeah, so I thought about something we could do. So what was this? You talk about your most memorable part, your favorite part or memorable part, the most thoughtful part of not the resurrection story, but the Good Friday story. In the Bible, what happened leading up to Good Friday?
What is my most memorable?
Yeah, part of the whole story.
I don't know. My mind always goes to this part, and I think it's because we did it in the play last. Is that at the play last year, or I just remember reading it? Mm-hmm. This is a part where I think it's after Jesus. Was on the donkey riding through, I don't know the area name. Mm-hmm. And then he was with his disciples. I think it was about nighttime. He was with his disciples. And I guess some either Greek or Roman military prince or whatever. I don't remember exactly who and whom. But they sent out for somebody to go and get Jesus. And Peter, was trying to defend Jesus, and he took out a knife and cut the soldier's ear off. And then Jesus told him, you know, stop, it's okay, whatever. And then Jesus just, as usual, healing the man that heals and everything, he put his hand over the soldier's ear, and the soldier's ear was healed. So I found that, I know it's like some small tiny piece to the whole marvel story about Jesus and the resurrection, but I feel like it stuck to me because that person who was thinking Jesus was this bad person that, oh, they sent to go and get him because he did something bad, but to see that someone they portrayed to be as a bad person do something good and still end up going with them, knowing what is gonna happen. Mm-hmm. It's a thought for that person themselves to say, hey, this man might is probably not the person that they portrayed
themselves to be.
So yeah, that's just why that story kind of stuck with me. That short part, but it stuck with me.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Similar is that Judas betrayed him, and then Jesus called it. He called it, right? And Peter denied him, and he also called it. And when Peter, when Jesus first told Peter that, somebody here is going to deny me three times or whatever before the cock crows, and all of them were like, nope, not me, not me, not me.
I can't, not me, Lord. And then, but Peter, like, Peter was in a position where he denied him, like, one time, two time, and three time. And then when the cock crowed, that's when he remembered what happened. He remembered what God prophesied and said that was gonna happen. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, you can say in such conviction that, no, I'm not going to do this. I'm going to be strong. I am not going to do this. But you, circumstances push you where you do things and you do mess up. Mm-hmm. But the thing about that story is that Jesus knew they were going to do these things, and he still kept them in the fold. He still kept them in the fold, and he still died for their sins. Mm-hmm. He still died for their sins. He died for all the people that sent him on the cross sins. He died for all of us who weren't even born yet sins. Yeah. So it's just amazing that he knows these people are betraying him. He knows these people are doing the worst of the worst things to him for just being who he is, and he still died for that.
Yeah.
So that's just amazing part of that story for me.
So we're shooting the episode of Antiguan Kitchen, and of course the battery dies. So we just had to come up with use another device while the battery charged. So we're gonna check in behind the scenes of Antiguan Kitchen episode.
I don't have any salt in my dumpling because you have to boil the salt. So I'm going to crush it in. This is the potato dumpling section, and this is the white dumpling.
Okay. Hey guys! So it's another day. It's Saturday. It's Easter Saturday. And we don't have too much going on today, but besides a little work and, you know, house cleaning and that kind of stuff. But Miss Bendy, she's in the background. She's actually gonna be doing a dance for, we're recording a dance for our virtual Easter Sunday service. So you're gonna get to see a little bit of that now.
There's no more fighting left. Sinking to rise no more. Searching for that open door. And every road that I've taken led to my regret. And I don't know if I'm gonna make it. Nothing to do but lift my head. I look to you. I look to you.
It's Resurrection Sunday or Easter Sunday. So today is an awesome day. Of course, we're celebrating the day that Christ rose again. So we're missing the fact that we can't, you know, get dressed up for Easter, do the regular celebration. So this is what quarantine Easter Resurrection Sunday is looking like for us.
Living and in this time and in this season to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And so it is a good day for us to give God praise, good day for us to give him glory, and a good day for us to shout that he's no longer in the grave, but he is alive.
Okay, to close out this vlog and Easter weekend, we just want to say a thank you, thank you, thank you to all the frontline workers who are fighting on the front line this pandemic, right? COVID-19. Mm-hmm. No, some of you haven't seen your children in days, we know, a week. Some of you are, you know, depressed and working tirelessly to keep all of us healthy. So we want to thank you, nurses, doctors, all the medical staff, policemen, people in the fire station, all of the frontline workers. We want to say thank you, please. And to those especially that we know, Hope,
Lisa, Uncle Kelly, someone for our aunt,
many more. Thank you again.
Thank you.